Bleed! Bleed!
Oh, my arm!
Yeah, we're playing Bleed. I skipped the intro. Basically, there was six heroes. Who are the greatest heroes in the world, and we have to kill them all in order to become the greatest.
Oh, okay, so it's completely unlike that Wii game that you said on Twilight Sand.
Yeah, pretty much.
I wish I could remember any words. That would help.
Words are helpful. So, I beat this game today. And then I decided to try it over on the show. And on Blake's computer, I lost all my progress, so...
Why don't you use your secondary fire?
That doesn't seem to do anything. Maybe if I... Is the rocket launcher something different? No, it doesn't seem to do anything. So maybe I don't have access to that yet or something. Yeah, I already switched weapons. So this game's really cool. I really like it.
You've got a D so far. What does that mean?
Just means because I haven't gotten a lot of points yet. You basically, you get points for killing dudes and you lose points for getting hit and dying. And then you use those points to buy upgrades.
That's right,
stuff.
So they don't have, like, a traditional life system.
Oh, no, they do, so there's life in the top, right?
Lives system.
No. You have unlimited lives, basically. You just keep trying from the last checkpoint over and over.
But so the reason you don't want to die is because you don't want to waste your score?
Yeah, you don't want to lose score.
Oh, I see, and it's got ballet time, as they call it.
Yeah, it has ballet time, which is sometimes helpful and sometimes I do entire levels forgetting about it. So this is like a cute little indie game. Yeah.
Yeah, you know what? I've already done that.
Okay. Cool.
It is a nice little indie game. I gotta say that there's a lot of them I see out there. There's a lot of games out there that use, that don't have to, but like use a lot of gunplay. And I know people like guns. I've got nothing against games that have guns. But I like to think that it takes a little more imagination to come up with, no matter how many guns you come up with, to come up with gameplay that doesn't rely on guns, because the animation's a little bit more tricky in some ways, because you have to come up with, you want to create different animations for each attack style, and, you're being shot at rockets by a...
Yeah, there's a helicopter. So I've beaten this game so much, the last little while, that I've gone completely numb to everything
dun,
that happens.
Dun, dun,
dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun, dun. Alright, there you go. Oh yeah, those are nice. Oh, I screwed that up.
This reminds me of Bad Dudes. I don't think that this dude is bad enough to stay in the present.
No, we will try and kill the present, actually.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
That's really a sign of the times, eh? In the 80s, it was like the president was your buddy, you were going to go like...
Oh, and this is a cute little thing.
Yikes, I thought this was going to be... How silly, right?
This game is cute.
apparently it's semi-cute.
It's semi-cute. This game is really... Ah! And by the way, the heroes are weird and kind of upsetting.
Well, they're just bosses. They're just bosses. They've called them heroes. But really, they're just... This is the boss from the first dungeon in...
My
Kid Icarus. No, second dungeon?
I think it's the second dungeon. I don't recognize him. I never got further than the first dungeon. Oh, God. Oh, God. So I screw this up, and I only have, one health left, and I don't want to die.
Good. Then don't. That's all. You must have wanted to die.
I must have wanted to die. My mouse got stuck.
Gam-Uber! Vancouver?
That's the greatest city on Earth, according to people who like Vancouver a lot, I guess.
Indie games with guns in them, I know it's easier to come up with stuff with a gun in them, and when you're already coming up with a bunch of other innovative gameplay,
mm-hmm.
Hey!
Whoa, crap!
C.
I totally did not see that
E.
That's my name! And yours too, I guess.
I know when you're coming up with a lot of innovative gameplay things, and people like guns, so it's really hard to come up with reasonable ways. But you look at, the greatest games ever. Very few of them have guns as their primary mode of interaction with the environment. Very good level clear.
Yeah! I got 879 points.
But Super Mario Brothers, right? You jump on your enemies. It was... Asteroids, yeah, you shoot game things, and Galaga, and there's a bunch of other shooting games, but... you look at some of like the top, a Donkey Kong, you don't shoot anything, you don't have to fight anything, but it's optional. And there's all kinds of great games out there that just don't use guns. Or like Mega Man, yeah, it has guns, but its guns are so different from each other.
Yeah.
So fundamentally different. There isn't anything that's just sort of like a handgun or a machine gun or like a rocket launcher.
Mm.
Even Metroid, there's guns in it, but there's freeze rays. There's a lot of unusual things. And those games were already made, so we don't really need to repeat what was already in them.
Well, it depends, honestly, what the game is going for. This game is going for specifically gunplay and interesting, crazy things.
Yeah, what if she, like, I don't know, well, it's kind of stereotypical for the female to shoot arrows, but what if she, like, shot arrows, or what if she just flipped everywhere and, like, threw daggers at people? That would be cool.
That's cool. You do get a katana if you want. It's one of my favorite weapons.
That's fair enough. But I read some developer, I think it was the guy behind Gears of War, but it might have been another developer, who said basically that the reasons why they have so many games with guns in them is because we have all these interesting environments. And he said, and may have been the guy who did Gears of War, I don't remember specifically if it was him or another, like, but it was a AAA developer like that, who said we haven't really come up with more unique ways of interacting with the environment, so for now, we use guns. That's what he said.
Part of the big thing is that we have 20, 30 years of video game development, and at this point, we've had a lot, especially with first-person shooters, we've had the last 20 years, yes, we have the last 20 years of figuring out how to interact, use guns to inflict violence on things. So it's something we've gotten very good at. So it's basically, if you want to concentrate on something else, or it's something that there's already a preset, set of rules to go by.
Yeah, it's like okay, so I can give them the rocket launcher, and I can give them like two interesting guns that they haven't used, you know, before. Like one that turns your enemies into slime that you can then ride down hillsides to increase your speed, and one that every time you shoot something, it slows down the nearest enemy to it and makes everything go position around that enemy in like a little vortex.
The neatest gun that I've seen actually. Like, that was actually original, and it's one of the few truly original weapons that I've seen in a long time. It's actually in Saints Row 4.
He said Saints Row 4, by the way.
Yeah, I can't say any of those words. But there was a...
Oh boy!
There was a dubstep gum that has this little, like, mini-game. So, like, when it says, like, the music, it's shooting little tiny little pellets. And then when it goes... it shoots, like, a big, huge rocket blast. So it's all about the timing... your shots along with the song, and it's the same song, and so it's all about getting used to the song, so it turns into sort of a rhythm game about timing off your rockets and your bullets all at the same time, and it's one of the functions of the game, which is why I like Saints Row, honestly, it's because it tries to be creative. It doesn't always succeed, but it tries.
Anyway, I've never made a game that's successful by international standards, but then it's just me making stuff on my own, and I'm not good at the graphics portion, which I know a lot of people are really interested in, especially with an indie title.
It's really important to, because it sets your game up immediately, especially with,
yeah.
If you want to do anything like with like Greenlight, which I don't think you've had any experience or even tried.
No.
Greenlight is all about, specifically about attracting people by... Oh crap!
By the look of it.
Okay. By the look of it, yeah. It's about creating a nice trailer. Oh my god!
I didn't realize there was even two of those guys.
Yeah, there's two of them jumping around.
Okay.
It must have been nice for them to whatever. I should actually be paying attention to the plot, but I've already beaten it. So I don't care! Ha ha! I have 13. Should I get the flamethrower? I'm gonna get the flamethrower. Wait, what's the next level?
Oh, get the heart plus. Heart plus. You need heart plus.
Yeah, I guess. What's the next level? Robot.
How many bosses are there in this?
There's six and then the final one. Should I get energy? I'll get
energy. Are you gonna beat this in like tonight?
I don't know, maybe.
Does it get harder and longer? Does it get longer?
Not really longer, but it gets harder. Alright,
So it sounds like. How many times. Never mind, I won't even make that. It's not worth it. You're an audience, I hate you all, but you're above that.
You're above that. It's gonna do 1 second. Pause for a second! Okay, so one more minute.
I was actually timing.
Oh, were you timing it?
Yeah, using the.
Okay.
That's what I said earlier.
Oh, sorry, I didn't.
That's okay, we'll just.
We'll edit this out in post!
Yeah, this part I will edit out.
Okay, so we'll just do one more.
Edit!
Okay. And we're back! Brendan was being totally unjustifiably paranoid. Okay, so this level is. Ow! Cool. Because each level has like a neat little mechanic, little mechanics attached to it.
I do like that. Although I have to say that Jumpman has a new mechanic in it.
Jumpman.
Jumpman was interesting because in every level they had a different concept.
Yeah, it was basically a different half game every time.
Yeah, a different half game. But there were levels that you had a weapon. There was one weapon where you, one level where you had a gun, and one level where you threw javelins.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's the last time you played a game where you throw javelins?
God of War.
Do you throw javelins?
I think that's one of the weapons. It's been awesome to play God of War, to be honest. Oh God! See, this one has these little lasers, which then, if you screw up, summon these little mini bots.
Sort of like what I already did in Flags of Doom.
Yeah, kind of.
They must have stolen that.
I've
made a few games, but none of them have been. I haven't really tried to sell any of them, and I don't think they're really worth selling.
I think Flags of Doom, if you.
If I changed the graphics and I got rid of some of the bugs, it could maybe sell. But when I make a game, I really try and focus on having. Not having guns in it unless absolutely needed. Not that those guns are bad, but just as a design challenge to myself.
Mm-hmm.
To come up with games that don't need guns, and then maybe give it like an optional gun in like one level or something like that.
Yeah.
But like, that's what I tried to do with Flies of Doom, and there was like two levels that were about five levels out of the 130 that had guns in them.
Mm-hmm.
And I was pretty happy with that. You got a game over.
I got a game over. Okay. So next time on the Super Spears Brothers, we will continue our discussion on violence in video games.
That's not really what we're discussing.
Shut up! We're totally discussing that! I was going to do a bunch of sound effects, but I'm just dying to robots. Why am I so chill?
Genetics.
Alright. And we have returned! Okay, not yet.
Keep going. Keep surviving. This counts for something.
Ah!
It's the next level.
You're trying to figure out my phone and it's locked. And I know it's locked. And I can't describe the password to you.
Is it over?
It's a weird Zed.
I thought it was a Zed. That's what I tried to do. Wait, we just told everyone on the internet.
It's my cell phone. Bingo unlock is a weird looking Zed.
Yeah.
Oh, I said that. I don't know why I did that. Ah, crap! I forgot he was shooting rickets. So we're back. You're shooting rickets.
Rickets.
Don.
Oh, you got rickets.
Ah, I got rickets. Why am I zoomed up so much? Oh yeah, that's right. Cause I'm fighting this guy.
You're fighting a boss. Did you know that?
Yeah. I'm used to playing with different weapon loadouts. I forgot I haven't gotten any of them yet. So that's why I was dying so terribly on that last bit because I was so used to.
That was some good dodging.
I was so used to having the flamethrower by this point.
Hey everybody, play along at home. Shoot.
Just shoot wildly.
Shoot wildly in all directions and then die.
Yeah, that sounds fair.
You were more successful than I expected. And you got a D.
And this part is really cool. I figured this out by complete accident. See, look at this. How are we going to get through here, right? It doesn't look like there's a way to get through here. I know, I'm just going to jump up and dash through. That'll get me through. Nope, set him off. But luckily, it already showed you earlier that if you shoot the buttons, see that red button? Shoot it, the door opens. So you just have to keep running, because these little robots are going to keep coming forever.
Oh, there's a level in Donkey Kong Country Returns that's just like
terrible. And usually I get better than that.
But can I just point out that the graphics, this were obviously made in Spriter?
Oh, totally.
These are Spriter graphics, and they couldn't not be Spriter. those of you who don't use Spriter, anyway, in the previous episode, I was talking about game design and how I try and avoid using guns. They're a bit of an easy out. This game does use the guns well. White Milk 2?
MK. Milk 2. The boss in this game also. Everything, I don't know, I like all the little bits in this game. It's not I won't say it's an amazing game, but it's really cool and fun. It does some interesting things.
Cool and fun, everybody. We just explained why he likes the game. Cool and fun.
Yeah, it's like a Chest of Cheetah.
Like
too cool for. Too cool? Is that the game?
Too cool to be a cheetah.
I guess. You think he wouldn't be too cool because he lives in the. I was just gonna say, I got hit. That's amazing. I'm terrible at this boss. Yeah. I'm terrible at this boss.
You know what? I'm terrible at not loving you.
Aw.
I'm so terrible at loving you.
Oh, I almost made it.
And loving you.
That's okay, though. We got this.
When I met you, and I loved you, like a brother to his wife.
Wait, what?
Like a brother does his wife.
I love you like a brother does his wife.
Yeah, no, that's actually not any real. I was trying to frame it as something less weird, because it's like, yeah, because as he does his wife, so, you know, just normally sex, and I was like, as I love my brother, like, the way that he has sex with his wife, so no, that doesn't work.
You know, I do love you like the way I have sex with my wife. Infrequently! Heyo!
Heyo!
Up top!
I can't. I'm getting shot if I... okay, now I can. Yeah!
I was really hoping
enforced
you
enforced celibacy.
I really would. I was hoping you wouldn't give me a high five for that terrible joke.
Hooray!
Points were 658. You are a loser.
Whose idea was it to make a robot into a hero, anyways?
That's not very funny.
No, this game isn't terribly funny, but it's nice. I like it. 752. Can I upgrade anything really worthwhile? Not really. I keep.
Don't you? You need that flamethrower.
I really want the flamethrower. The next level isn't terribly useful for a flamethrower.
All
right. It's mostly the robot level. I'm just doing everything on normal.
All right. So this level's Race War. We wanted to play this game two players, but then we realized we couldn't get our controller to work, and it only works with an Xbox 360 controller, which we have, not one that will work on the PC.
Yeah.
On this PC.
This level's neat too, because it has these guys, but also because you're on a train, and see that thing flashes, and then that, and if you're up top, you just fucking die.
Well, that's a nice mechanic. I like that.
Yeah. Oh, well, this game's full of nice little mechanics.
I actually think that exact thing happens in Bad Dudes. Actually, I think it's exactly a Bad Dudes level.
I think I'm just gonna hide under here so that kills off all the dead.
We're fine!
Why are we working for this woman?
We've got bunnies. Deadly bunnies are dead.
Oh, the bunny slipper jets! I never just noticed that. I'm too busy screaming in agony as I'm shooting them with bullets.
Your emphasis was on slipper there. Did you realize they were bunnies, but not slippers?
Yeah, I realized they were bunnies, but I didn't realize they were actually just bunny slippers. That's adorable. I like this. This makes me feel like I'm just in a shitty 90s action film. Just running forward, shooting randomly.
Adorable the Explorable. Actually, that sounds horrible. Let's say that again. Hello, I am Adorable the Explorable.
That's so bad. I haven't done this level very much, so I'm not used to this. Nope, I'm not gonna help at all.
Don't stand there.
See the bullet time mechanic's kind of neat because it actually gives you more time. It actually gives you more time to shoot the boss. So I'm doing this like I'm actually getting.
Oh, the shot, the bullets are your bullets at the same speed, but you're...
They move slightly slower, I think, but faster than.
Oh, that was good.
Yeah.
I didn't expect you to get like that. And now the Matrix fights. You fight Matrix.
Next, we're gonna fight all the Matrix. Oh, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna chase back to the thing. But it's slow moving, oh god.
Well, it's actually fast moving because it's moving at the speed of the train.
That's true. This game is kind of. It's like a cross between like a platformer and like a bullet hell kind of thing.
Is it like a twin stick shooter?
It's basically a twin stick shooter side scroller. Like, that's one thing I like about this game, is it doesn't do anything particularly original, but the various mixture it does is new. Which is what's neat about it. And plus, it's just fun. It's nice.
I'll tell you the one game I made that was all about guns.
Mm-hmm.
It was that game, Penguin Hunt 98.
Oh, yeah, right.
This person's fast. So you have to use all your bullet time on her, basically.
She just stands still, but when she's dashing around, you do bullet time, you can actually see her and hit her. Then she's gonna come by. I'm gonna die. I should just accept that.
Folks, we're all gonna die. Thing do 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 doesn't actually make.
It's like standing up and leaning forward when you're holding the controller. It totally does.
Jump while holding the controller.
Yeah, you should have tried to use the six axis that doesn't exist.
So I can see how you beat this game fairly quickly because of the mechanic of just you want a good score, but if you don't care about score, you just beat the game.
Yeah, but also it took me a while because I am OCD and did every level like 30 times so I can upgrade everything.
Oh, I see.
Like, I'm not doing any leveling at all. I usually go, oh god! I usually do a lot of grinding.
I'm obsessive about my definitions, and OCD is not really what OCD is. So I have a compulsion that's causing some disorder that causes me to have to tell you that OCD is not what you just said it was.
being obsessive about things?
Well, it has to be a disorder. Anything that is a disorder. People who think that they have a disorder because they are kind of, they do something that's on the list. They read a list and they go, oh my god, I've got this because I read the things. If it's not...
Well, look at creating, a pained little expression.
If it's not creating disorder in your life, then it's not actually a disorder. That's what makes it a disorder.
Yeah, take a bullet to the gut.
That's
I like how bored she is. It's like, yeah, I'm on the train. Okay, now she's excited, but before.
Take a bullet to the gut sounds like it's gonna be our new song that we can pitch to, who are those guys that...
Should I get more health or should I get... I'm gonna get the flame.
Who's the guy that... Andy Samberg? We'll pitch take a bullet to the gut to Andy Samberg.
That sounds fair.
Whoa, I took a bullet to the gut. Whoa,
oh, my life is in a rut. Where did I get here? Where did I get here?
You know what, we'll pitch it, he'll write it. We'll pitch it, he'll write it.
And probably sing it and produce it and get all the money.
Oh, look, it's a Voltorb.
Yeah. Oh, what am I supposed to do? Oh, yeah, the door really slowly opens. Oh, crap. Wait, actually, oh, also, you only have two weapons at a time, but you get to change your layout out. I'm just a pistol and flamethrower. I got that. And I'm gonna switch to Nope. There's no ammo or anything in this game. It's just each weapon behaves differently.
Why?
So it's pretty much whatever behavior you want. Cause it only does it's slow shooting.
That's got more flaming than
my life.
I wanted to say the name of that Everett guy who's a gay actor, or possibly Stephen Fry.
God, I don't like this poet.
Shoot.
See, this is totally Quick Man. Quick Man? Yes, Quick Man.
This is the Quick Man stage.
Yeah, except not quite.
But not as
pretty
quick.
Pretty much. And there's actually some puzzly stuff it does later.
That
little bit there was teaching.
I'm puzzled.
See?
Later.
This guy takes his laser wing very seriously.
Does your bullet time run out, or just like, I know I can see it run out, but I mean, does it, like, do you have a limit to how many times it can recharge, or does it...
No. There's actually different characters you unlock by beating the game. Oh, God! That do different, from what I can tell, I've only locked the one, but, it charges your bullet time differently.
By the way, this one,
it just recharges, but, oh God, I hate this one.
By the way, Brendan unlocked several things, and then we went to play it, and they were not unlocked.
Yeah.
So I think that's just because he switched to computers or something.
I'm sure that when I get home. How did I survive that?
Hey, let's do a count of how many female action stars have pink hair. Go.
Next time I see Super Brothers. I don't know.
Erin Insurance.
Yeah, what's her name? Flo from the insurance commercials.
Wait, hang on, are those both from the same thing?
Ah!
I think so.
See, this boss is only one of which is terrible. So I just don't have to make it up. Okay, so start here.
Yeah. We're playing No More Heroes 2. No More Heroes.
Oh yeah, No More Heroes. That's what this is totally stealing from.
Yeah, except I think No More Heroes is a lot worse.
Probably as far as I understand that game, it's 90% toilet. But it is Japanese. So everything from Japan is 90% toilet.
This boss is basically just three big balls. It is the juggler's worst nightmare. Go on, juggle me!
Come on, man!
Come on, do you know Mills Mess? Can you do Mike's Barrage?
Oh, some chainsaws, huh? I was a meta parody of that joke.
Well, parody of people who make jokes are bad people.
That's true.
You're really sucking this one.
This one is hard. This boss is just hard to dodge. You think it won't because it's just straight lines, but got him.
Oh. Surprised that
you did. Now we're at the halfway point. Okay, I think I might want to film for this.
You know, I don't know
what to do. Oh, no, I don't. 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 See these little laser things? As long as you don't shoot them, they grow.
So you have to keep shooting. I had an enemy like that in Penguin Height Hunt 99.
Did you? I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. I can't dodge that.
Is that just unfair?
It's randomized, so sometimes you get trapped in it, but you get hit.
Mm-hmm. Something you can do about it. Penguin at 99 was my attempt to make a sort of a...
Like a Gradius style.
Well, it wasn't really Gradius style. It was more like an Asteroids.
As Asteroids meets Gradius, really.
It was Asteroids plus Gradius, that's right. It was a combo. And it was not my most original game, I must admit.
There's one you made me for Christmas on my birthday or something?
Yeah, I did. Though I didn't really finish it. But what was interesting about it is it had those...
Oh, right, I've only done this level once. Oh, okay.
Is that water death? I guess it must be.
I don't know. I don't want to find out.
Maybe you swim in it and you can find secrets down there.
Maybe. This game isn't big on secrets.
Aren't you about to die?
Oh, I'm totally about to die. I'm not doing well all of a sudden. This is the boss that I'm least familiar with because I've only beat it the one time.
And then you're like, I'm not going back to the water again.
Yeah, it's not my. It's kind of not the most interesting.
This boss is very gradius.
This actually reminds me of one of the ones from Mega Man X2, I think.
Hey, maybe you could have gotten through some of those trapped areas using your
almost definitely. But I didn't, because I didn't think of it. Both time I forget about it, which is stupid. That was much easier.
Okay. The boss is gone now. Bye-bye, robot man.
Oh, no, I'm not done yet. I thought that was it.
Oh. You were unfamiliar with this boss.
Wow.
You didn't realize that there was actually an after boss.
See, this is like the... I remember this bit. This bit's cool. I like this. This is actually the final level, I think. The second final level uses a similar mechanic, but much cooler.
But inverse?
Kind of. The big balls that fall down and land on you. Yeah, this boss. So that's why I didn't recognize him, because he wasn't in the boss rush at the end. By the way, this game ends in a boss rush.
Oh, that's a totally original idea.
Again, this game doesn't do anything original, just at the beginning.
Even the death is a little bit Mega Man. I guess it's supposed to be a bit Mega Man.
Yeah, this game rails its influences pretty
much. So, the guy who made Mega Man, whatever his name is...
Japanese McJapanese.
Japanese McJapanese.
That's the most Japanese name I could think of, sorry.
And it's like, oh, hi, I'm Japanese McJapanese. Oh, I'm really from Tokyo. I've been there all my life. Listen, when I grew up in this Tokyo, I used to design games, and I used to dress up in a little schoolboy outfit. It was the way we all had to dress when we were doing our Japanese flower arranging.
Desu ne! There you go. I'm totally Japanese.
Our animations were called anime, which is basically our Japanese term. This is my Japanese accent. Japanese term for our animation style.
Bam! I got me mid-explosion.
Hi, Casper.
We have another special guest.
Unlike last time, it's Casper. Next time, it'll be Grant Kirkhope.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm on the second last level already. I am 36 points from getting more health. I could get the revolver, which is useless, that which I can afford, and the shotgun, which I've never used.
Basically, you're full up on everything.
Yeah, the katana's really useful, but I don't have enough yet.
Oh. Move is beating hard. Hi, Casper. We're playing another game that's appropriate for your age level.
Yeah, especially this one that's full of dragon guts. Oh, this... I don't like this bit. See, you know you had to get inside a giant dragon? So, you had to get inside of an apple. So then you go inside a stomach. But it's sliding, and then if you just mess up, you just die.
That's cool. This level reminds me a lot of one of the levels in Super Ghouls and Ghosts.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very similar level. Same spikes, same enemies, same overall graphical style. Casper, don't actually crawl on Uncle B while he's doing... He's going inside the human body.
I wonder if this is what I look like on the inside.
No, you look sadder than that on the inside.
I look very sad on the inside.
Anyway, that Scottish guy who invented Rockman. Oh, it's Rock! No, it's pronounced Rockman, you dilly bats!
I gotta pause for a second.
Yeah.
Casper, you're being silly.
Casper's being silly. Are you being silly, Casper?
Yeah.
Now. Okay, I can do this. So this is hard mode when you have a baby crawling on you at the same time.
He's not a baby, Casper. Are you a big boy? Anyway.
See, this is hard.
It does make it more difficult.
Yeah.
Casper, are you getting up on Uncle B?
Are you
Casper,
getting up on my grill?
Are you wearing a diaper right now? Oh, that's a good sign. Casper is currently twerking.
Yeah.
Casper, do you like to twerk?
Yeah.
Why not?
Because of Miley Cyrus? Did she ruin it for you?
Yeah. Because, you know, as they say in New Orleans, that's really what she did and what most people do as twerking isn't really true twerking, Casper. There's a lot of slut-shaming that goes on when it comes to twerking, Casper. Yeah, don't touch the screen. Don't touch the computer, Casper. Casper, don't touch the computer. I will take you away. Keep touching the computer. That's it. Yeah, that's it. You can touch that part. That's okay. Just don't touch the screen, okay? No, don't touch that part. Don't touch that part. That part's okay. Touch that part.
Yeah, I've also only done this part once. That I did
Don't touch that part.
And I just bullet rushed right into a bullet.
Okay. That's a part.
You can touch that part, yeah. That's just a sticker.
That's just a sticker.
Don't touch that part.
Okay, you can touch that part.
Oh, no,
don't
I didn't
touch that part.
You want to touch that part? Okay, go ahead.
Don't touch that part. Just,
yeah, you can,
not
touch
doing
all,
well.
You can touch all the stickers. Yeah, it doesn't help that you have somebody crawling on you.
No.
That part, you can touch that sticker too, yep. That part's okay too.
Don't touch that.
Okay, you touch that part. That shows that we're energy efficient.
Don't touch that.
That's the same sticker, but it's a different part of it. Yeah, that part says
that
we're running Windows 7.
Don't touch that.
Oh, Casper, you've got 2 minutes. And I think so do we, actually.
Yeah. This is going to time out nicely. Okay, easy mode activated. Oh, yeah. This is the bubble machine. The bubble core.
Look, Casper, see the bubble machine?
This is also very Mega Man.
It's shooting bubbles. See all the bubbles? Would you like to have a bubble machine that shot bubbles like that? Why not?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Yeah. Casper, your mom is very quietly saying 2 minutes past that.
I like it when we have Casper, because I feel the no need to do any commentary whatsoever. I think he does my job for me.
That's
he says everything
that's
I need
a
to say.
Play keyboard, Casper. You can play with it, but just don't knock it down. Or snap it. Out.
Oh, right. Sorry, I stopped looking at this. I stopped paying any attention to the screen whatsoever.
Yeah, you heard that, Casper. That's in your heart?
No, I was distracted by my score.
Which is zero?
Yeah. I mean, it's 1362, whatever that means. I think that's my total.
1362 is a bad year to live in Europe.
It's a bad year to live almost anywhere, probably.
It's probably not bad to live in
China
First
was,
Nations land.
Yeah, China probably was no better or worse than any other given time.
Oh my god. You just have to do a couple more. Now you're being crawled on again.
And he has my hand pinned. Okay, I got my hand free. Oh, no!
Look at all the smoke. Do you see all the smoke? Is that funny?
Uh-huh.
See, this is what I was talking about earlier. This part's neat. With the bubbles.
This isn't the last level.
There's one more level after that, so it's pretty much the boss rush. Wait up until I get to the end of the game. It took me a lot longer the first time, oh my god.
And yet you were doing better?
I was doing better in parts.
Casper, look at all the bubbles. See all the bubbles?
He's very valiantly climbing.
That's right.
Like, he's like Mount Everest climbing, you
know. Ah, that's
he's got
me.
Little spikes.
Ah, that's me.
Yeah, that's some juice. Mostly water.
I'm drinking juice.
That's Uncle B's juice.
That's my juice. That's what I need to keep myself alive.
Uncle B brought juice just for him. His special Uncle B juice.
I want juice too.
You want juice too? Well, we don't have any more juice. That's all.
Oh yeah, see, this is when it gets neat, because then the dragon starts moving. Yeah. This is like my favorite part of the game, I think, actually.
This is a lot. This actually does happen very close to this in Super Ghouls and Ghosts.
Yeah.
Because the Super Ghouls and Ghosts level also although it doesn't move around with such free physics, of course. It
wasn't physics weren't invented yet.
Physics hadn't been invented yet, then. That's right. Physics were invented by the left-wing conspiracy media that wants to ruin all action movies by having physics.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so, next time on Super Spears Brothers.
Thanks for turning off the computer, Casper.
I turn install off.
Alright, so we survived.
Barely, by the skin of our teeth.
Barely?
Ah!
We were supposed to never mention that name.
No, yeah, we signed a pact.
So anyway, Brendan, you like defending indie games. Tell them what happened.
So the two-year-old, my brother's son.
Hey, he's two.
Two and a half, sorry. In his flailing around trying to get attention, hit the off button. And said, oh god! Which caused everything to go flippity.
Dude, we actually lost all the videos we've made so far.
Yeah.
Luckily that turned out to be a temporary problem and they're all back now.
Yeah.
It was very scary.
We just like stood there, just like,
Did we lose everything?
Because we have, I don't know if we've mentioned this, but we have a ridiculous backlog. Like, I don't know when this episode's going to come out. It's probably about 3 months after we record it.
Yeah.
We have a huge backlog going, and so we thought we lost it all. Like, I guess we can just film more.
It feels like I should do a backup of everything, but I don't think I've got the computer for that. So if you guys want to donate $700, I will get a backup.
Yeah, see, here's the... And then I'll be shooting the Heart of a Dragon, by the way.
You're shooting the Heart of a Dragon. You gotta shoot that.
Oh, no, did you just, that was,
it doesn't even matter if you live in a zoo or a pile of shoes.
It really doesn't, I'm just like,
you gotta shoot that heart of a dragon till it shows you the way. Shows you how to get to Sesame Street.
Oh, wait.
I think you've lost the plot here a little bit.
Oh my god, you could actually do this. You could actually do this. Oh.
Oh. I guess not. I wasn't paying attention to how much health I had.
That's why I was all excited about you actually.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's a little bit of Mila Jovovich.
Yeah, a little bit.
Jovovich.
From the Resident Evil movies, otherwise known as My Wife is Awesome, guys. Check her out.
You know what? I haven't seen any of those movies, but the one I was actually thinking of was the one.
The other one?
No. Another one where she shoots things randomly.
Oh, the one that's trying to be equilibrium?
Yeah, that's the one.
Which is kind of sad, because equilibrium is pretty much trying to be 80 million other things.
Level clear!
That's so cool. Now we've beaten the six heroes, and we've beaten the game.
Inaccurate. The level is very opaque.
That's true. In fact, it became more opaque once we beat it.
Actually, it started off being translucent.
And so...
Maybe it was clear.
Oh my god.
First level was clear.
Oh my god! And so the dragon's defeated. The wheat had been cut from the chaff. The world is a new hero. A true hero.
Me!
You beat what's your face?
No, I don't want to.
I'm the one who killed the dragon!
Can you be this guy then?
No, I don't want to.
The Belko and I had a great blast! I will broadcast my induction to the Hall of Heroes tonight!
What a jerk.
So the world can properly celebrate its true hero!
Who does that guy look like? He looks like somebody.
Naruto, a little bit.
Yeah, Naruto with a little bit of, like, sock puppet.
A little bit, yeah.
I'm the hero, me!
Oh, by the way, the plot of this game is the fact that that guy made us to be a hero. And now he's taking the credit for it. And so now, we're gonna go kill him.
Oh, you know what? It totally reminds me of my last boss at the bakery. Don't want to get too personal about this, but, the guy who was my boss at the last bakery was a total dick, and I'm gonna name him right now. It's...
We'll just leave the exception box. So this is the Hall of Heroes, so it has elements from all the previous levels.
Oh, okay. So does it have the fifth element?
Yeah.
Oh, Miley Jones, Miley Cyrus.
Miley Cyrus 2.
Cypress Hill.
Yeah.
So I'm just jump around.
Everybody make a sound.
Insane in the membrane.
Insane!
I don't remember. Wait, Cypress Hill, they do hip-hop?
They do the hippity hop with the bippin' and the boppin' and the woozin' and the whatsin'.
That's pretty much their song. I can't remember who actually made it.
Did you see that? That was
One Tree Cypress Hill, though. Good
oh
show.
My god! Did you? That was amazing. I didn't stop. I didn't try to dodge anything. I was like, that one.
And then you got shot with a particularly easy laser.
Yeah, just a straight line.
Oh, this is just Super Mario Brothers 3 all over again.
This is Mega Man as hell.
That is very Mega Man as hell.
Yeah.
If hell
I actually, when I first played this, that's literally exactly the words I said.
Hell is another Mega Man.
That's true.
Mega!
Oh god, yeah, no, that would be hell.
We're having a real mega time! Oh, we're having so many megas!
I just had the saddest realization. Mega Man is essentially has the same career trajectory as Sonic.
Hey, I don't understand how that works.
Because it started off really good and then got progressively worse and worse.
I don't think it got progressively worse and worse. I think after, the second one is the best, unlike Sonic.
Well, after...
Which the first one's the only good one.
Well, the second one's actually better. But no, I meant like previously after Super Nintendo.
Cloud. But yeah. But with the goggles of Sid.
Yeah, there you go. Okay, this guy's... Ah! That guy... Oh yeah, you have to do the boss rush first. It's a reverse boss rush. You have to do the reverse order. And there's two of these.
Also, you have to fight the backwards.
Yeah.
Also, you have to reverse the polarity.
But you've got to reverse the polarity! Reverse all the polarities!
Polarities all over the goddamn place. We have to reverse all of them.
I just remembered that reversing the polarity helped me remember the name of the actor at the very, very end of Back to the Future 2.
What's that?
Polarity.
Oh, yeah.
He reverses the polarity.
Oh, he totally does.
Bam!
Okay, so I'm just gonna... See, now there's two of each one.
Joe Flaherty was in the televised series Maniac Mansion.
It was a televised series of Maniac Mansion?
It's not very close to the books. By books, I mean the video.
Yeah, what? You are blowing my mind for a second, though.
That's called a mind job.
Oh, I see.
I do mind jobs in the corner for $5.
Hey, man, did you know that the largest organism on the planet is a mushroom?
Oh, I just came in my own head.
I came knowledge. I came, I saw, I learned.
I had a knowledge gasm.
Yeah.
Knowledge gasm, guys, make that popular.
I won't. Because we can't even do this popular.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Well, okay, let's go. You did remarkably well.
Yeah.
I remember.
This is not actually...
Therefore, it must be remarkable by definition.
See, the thing is, the bosses have half the health. They have the same health as the dude. There's two of them. So it's actually not twice as difficult.
That's dumb.
There's just twice as much stuff here.
But which weapon are they all weak against?
See, theoretically, you're supposed to have multiple upgrades at this point, but I just haven't.
You haven't bothered. you haven't redone the levels with the upgrades.
Yeah,
this is an all-pistols run.
Yeah, pretty much. No, I used the flame for
you're
a
just
bit.
Basically
and the rocket launcher.
This is an all-Badoof run.
Yep.
I have to say that I actually used my Badoof all the way through that game.
I used Militank through a huge time.
Militank.
It's not Militank.
Tank is the cow.
Yeah, no, I think it's milk.
It's milk.
Possibly. Jerry, could you pull that up on the bazooza?
What's the deal with all these Pokemon characters? Why?
Are they not as good as the original 150?
That does sound like a bit he would do. Oh wait, no, that.
if he was a Pokemon nerd, he probably would.
That's right. He is a.
Probably. Anyone who's into Superman is
boring. Oh, there's three of them!
Is it
cheating!
Well, there's two originally.
Oh gosh, that means there's four of them going on right now?
That's right.
God. Oh god, this totally just blew my mind.
It's my job.
Ah, stop doing that, Blake. I'm not paying you for it.
Don't do it unless I pay you for it.
Oh, yeah.
That's just a waste. That devalues your own work.
It does.
And that's the way why prostitutes never have sex with me, just outside of working conditions. Is they have too much respect for career choices.
See, this is where the... Yeah. Yeah, sure. The flamethrower is really close to this.
The thing is, like, unless you've got your proper certification, and you actually get at least your certification...
See, look at this. Here. Look at this.
I'm a journeyman prostitute.
Look at this.
Flamethrowing does work. Slappers only next time.
Okay.
Oh my god,
I like this boss, because he has the weapons you have access to. Except I don't have access to.
So he doesn't have weapons you have access
to. Well, he has the access to all the weapons. Okay, now, and see the katana deflects bullets, so he has the katana out if you don't shoot him.
Can you flame him?
Possibly, I don't try that. Yes. He doesn't use his pistol very much. First time I fought him, he just pistoled me the whole time, and then after that, I built some
pistol
beats.
Pistol beats.
That's an old reference.
Most people haven't heard of it.
Yeah.
Pistol Pete, folks, look it up. You won't like it.
Most likely.
I did. Oh, is he calling in an airstrike?
Yeah.
Is there an airstrike button?
I don't think so.
So
he has access to one thing you don't. See, this is his pistol. Now he's pistol.
How
No, he uses... Ah.
Oh, that guy's a real pistol. Yes, sir. Real pistol, that guy is.
He really is. So, next time...
I should have zagged when you should have zigged.
She has a point. So next time, we'll do more of this.
Well, hang on. Is there another 10 minutes of this?
That's true. This is the last boss.
So let's not...
Let's not do a whole new episode.
I hope that it isn't...
So slightly longer episode.
Remember when we were on the last boss of that other game, and it took us 3 episodes?
Yeah, I don't think there's gonna be too good of that. But then again, I'm not doing very well.
No, you're right. It might take another 10 minutes. All 5 more attempts.
Yeah, that's true. I don't like mines.
I don't like yours either. We made the same joke at the same time,
and we both made fun of each other for doing it.
Is that like some sort of joke?
Jinx. I guess so.
Does
so you need to buy me some Coke.
Who's the name of that guy who nobody likes because he stole jokes from Louis C.K.?
Dane Cook.
Dane Cook.
There's been a number.
Did Dane Cook and Louis C.K. have to like joke jinx each other and then they can't say any jokes at all for the next like 2 weeks?
Maybe. They did. I think actually the canceling of that was him going on Louis' show.
That's right. If you haven't seen Louis, guys, don't. It really sucks. It's the worst show ever. Everybody loves Louis.
That show nobody likes.
Nobody likes Everybody Loves Louis, but everybody likes Nobody Likes Louis.
Yeah, that's real.
Yeah!
That was really good. You actually got through that with like 1 health.
I died 3 times on that whole boss rush level.
That is good. That's good.
She did it! She beat him! This is the opposite of my normal life.
He was the hero!
Hooray for Rin! That's her name, apparently. We love you!
Giggity-goo!
Giggity-giggity-goo!
Woohoo, you with us!
And this is where she personally thanks the player.
I did it. Except, I guess, I always wanted to be a hero, but I never really had the chance until you came along. I'm sorry. I don't think I'll ever be able to do something like that.
This ending kind of makes me feel weird.
Just promise me, whatever dreams you have, you'll do your best to make them come true too, just like you did for me. Thank you. I hope we meet again someday.
Yeah, the ending's kind of weird. Ah, now we totally Mega Super Mario this.
Kite
Ame. Drones.
Took 5 seconds to come up with that name.
Yeah.
Frequency bots.
That's kind of cool.
Oh, I like that.
Rocket. Oh, I like that.
Oh, the robot. That's cute. That's a good name.
Laserbot.
Laserbot. No idea. No thought put into that.
Dragon spores.
Dragon spores.
No. They're bubbles.
Robo baddies. That's rather.
And then Guppy. Sixth best hero. Height. Species. Slug. Hobbies. Eating. Collecting. Baby animal. Get it.
So in one of these episodes, I'm going to explain about 7 of my different game ideas.
Possibly. Oh, this is.
Gibby and Stew. I like Stew better. I thought Stew was more difficult.
Me too.
White make 2?
Yeah.
Is this like what they upgrade to white people?
I think so.
Right now, white people are kind of lame, but once they get rocket launchers and robots and shooting things.
Mm-hmm. She's 6'2"?
She's tall. She must be... I think she's modeled after Pink.
Possibly.
Although I think Pink's short, anyway.
So, not really? Guessing, I don't think Pink has blonde pigtails.
These heroes are so similar for just being just bosses and levels.
Yeah.
I don't know, like the Pink or whatever with white yellow hair, Goldilocks there. She seems like the most not like just a boss.
Yeah.
Robot Masters.
See, these are all the robots that we fought at the end. Question mark. You don't even know his name.
Wait.
Well, we had more speed than him. Loves ice cream sundaes.
Can you get to unlock him now?
I think because we beat the game on normal, we unlock robot version of us.
Oh.
Which basically functions the same, but the only way of charging your super is by killing people. Yay! This game is sweet. Thank you all. You're the best players of all time.
She's got a really strangely shaped body.
It kind of looks like a dick.
Most women, when they get older, they develop pear-shaped bodies, but not reverse pears.
No, not dick-shaped bodies, usually. I'm really glad women, when they get older, just don't turn to giant penises.
I know some women that are big dicks.
That's true.
Well, folks, if you've got a big dick, you probably liked this episode, so congratulations. We're gonna quit now.